So we've talked some PC, lots of Xbox, and Nintendo at E3 2021, and although Sony and PlayStation didn't have a big reveal event or anything, we've learned from the various events across the internet over the past week that there are still plenty of things coming to PS4 and PS5. Don't you worry, we got 20 games to tell you about. A couple of things to note though, first a disclaimer, Battlefield 2042 and Elden Ring were technically revealed at the event before E3, they're awesome. Also, many games like Somerville that are listed as launch exclusives will probably arrive on PlayStation consoles eventually, but we don't want to list anything if we don't know how long the exclusivity deal is. Still, like I said, we got 20 games, so let's get started off with number 20 and talk Death Stranding Director's Cut. This is billed simply as coming soon to the PlayStation 5, and it's seemingly Hideo Kojima's Death Stranding, but with more stuff in it. It's interesting considering that the game itself was already completely up to his creative control, so we wonder what was really cut. We think maybe nothing was really cut, it's just a nod to films, and we think maybe it's just getting new and interesting content. If they can expand on the combat scenarios and maybe add some more stuff in the world, some fun things to do, we're here for it. Death Stranding is definitely not for every type of player, but we really like it, so we're looking forward to checking it out on PS5. Now, this was ported to PC not too long ago, so we already know that with some extra horsepower behind it, it can look great. Next, over at number 19, Fatal Frame Maiden of Black Water was announced at Nintendo's event, but it's a multi-platform release. It's essentially a re-release of a Wii U Fatal Frame game. Now, Fatal Frame games aren't everybody's cup of tea, but it is an underrated Japanese horror series involving camera stuff. In its heyday, it was really something else, and it definitely belongs here, so we're looking forward to playing that sometime in 2021. Next, over at number 18, we have Mortal Shell: The Virtuous Cycle. This was revealed at IGN's E3 event thing, and all we know is that it's coming soon, but essentially what it is more Mortal Shell content. Now, for those of you that don't know Mortal Shell, it is a absolutely underrated Souls-like game that gives new spins on the familiar RPG formula, and it is absolutely worth checking out. And the fact that we're getting more of it is totally a win. Next, over at number 17, we have Payday 3, which, as of just a couple of days ago, Starbreeze announced a release window for it. It is coming in 2023 for PC and console, so expect to play this on PlayStation, and although it's a while away, we're excited, because it's a good series and we're glad it's continuing. Next, over at number 16, we have Soulstice. Now, this was shown off at the PC Gaming Show, and it looks pretty awesome. It's action-oriented. They say that the game is 70% action, and it seems like it's taking a lot of cues from fast-paced, crazy action like Bayonetta or Devil May Cry, which, if you ask us, is right up our alley. As of right now, we know it's coming in 2022. Now, over at number 15, Super Monkey Ball Banana Mania Anniversary Edition is a collection of all the classic Super Monkey Ball games that really took the world by storm in the early 2000s. This was revealed at the Nintendo event, but we know that it is a multi-platform release, so we're really looking forward to that. It's dropping this October. Now, over at number 14, Far: Changing Tides is actually the follow-up to Far Lone Sails, a pretty underrated indie-style game that really takes a unique spin on an adventure. From what we've seen right now, it's PC and consoles with some gorgeous visuals, and we know that it's just simply billed as coming soon. Over at number 13, we have Salt and Sacrifice. This is the follow-up to Salt and Sanctuary, which was a big hit with a lot of people, and this looks to take things to an even crazier degree. And the trailer, full credit to the developers, showed us quite a bit. We saw characters, we saw items, we saw weapons, we saw combat, we saw some exploration. It's really pretty out there, full front and center. Even though it was a trailer, it was a meaty one that showed us a lot of good stuff. And from a raw gameplay perspective, so far it's looking really awesome. That's not even to talk about the other stuff, the story, the atmosphere, the vibe, all that, which we'll be able to probably see much easier, not in a flashy marketing trailer release. Still, we're really hyped about this one, and it's releasing in 2022. Next, over at number 12, we have Steel Rising. This is an action RPG from Spiders. They're the developers behind Greedfall and the Technomancer. And so far, this seems pretty cool. There's not too much to go on yet other than the pedigree, you know, the developers behind it. Spiders has been controversial for years with stuff like Mars Warlogs and Bound by Flame not being received very well, but little by little, they've gotten better at building some pretty interesting RPGs like the Technomancer, sort of, but Greedfall was pretty darn great when that released just a few years back, so that's why we have our eye on Steel Rising. We don't have a release date for it yet, but hey, more AA RPG style fans, this is something to look forward to. Next, over at number 11, we have Dolmen, which looks incredibly cool. This is like a space horror shooter. It looks like it's taking some inspiration from something like Dead Space, like the lone masked man taking on the horrors of space, but with way more action and just way more visually going on. It looks extremely chaotic. It looks like there's some cool melee action, just judging from some of the cinematic type stuff. I really think this one shows potential, even if it's early. I'm really spitballing from the trailer we do have, but when I hear space horror shooter, I can't help but just be at least interested. Sci-fi, cosmic horror, weird creatures, melee weapons, guns, you name it. We're certainly keeping an eye on it because it's from that new publisher that was announced, Prime Matter, and it's coming in 2022. Next, over at number 10, we have Trek to Yomi. This is a Devolver Digital game, which that enough should tell you because they put out some really interesting, sometimes quirky games. Trek to Yomi looks a little more serious, but really cool. You're like a samurai-style swordsman going on an adventure, and it looks like it's completely black and white and mainly in two-dimensional planes. But with some really cool swordplay and just a good cinematic style, sometimes just a good single-player adventure with cool combat and cool style is all we need. This looks like an excellent game for people that were fans of stuff more recently like Ghost of Tsushima or even something like Onimusha over to more 2D adventure stuff like Shadow Complex. This one has a lot of potential, and we're keeping an eye on it, and it's releasing in 2022. Next, over at number 9, a nice surprise reveal was the fact that LX2 is a thing. The original LX was a completely underrated game. Not a lot of people really talk about it anymore, but it was just a regular old solid sci-fi fantasy RPG. It released in 2017 and it did develop a little bit of a cult following, and now it's getting a sequel. We don't have a release date for it yet other than what we've seen. It says coming soon. Next, over at number 8, we have Jurassic World Evolution 2, which is a follow-up to the surprisingly great Jurassic World Evolution. We made it before buy video on it and we were surprised. It wasn't like a crappy movie tie-in game. It was actually a pretty awesome Jurassic Park spin on a park building formula. And now with a sequel, they could take it even further with a new setting, more dinosaurs, more gameplay concepts. We're pretty excited, and it's not often that we get excited about a game with the title of a movie slapped on it. So we're glad this game is getting another chance. And seemingly, if everything goes well, we'll be playing it this year because they've said it's releasing 2021. Next, over at number 7, we have Avatar: Frontiers of Pandora. This was revealed at the Ubisoft event. It's likely going to be a multi-platform thing. There's not really too much to go on it yet other than that you know Ubisoft has that Avatar license. They probably feel like they're sitting on a ton of cash with it, and they're working on the next thing. It's interesting that we've seen a glimpse of this before we've even seen a glimpse of James Cameron's next Avatar movie. Still, there's plenty of those in the works, so it makes sense to make a game. You either love or hate the world of Pandora and the world of Avatar. I personally am pretty into it, so I'm excited to see where this goes. Hopefully it's not too Ubisofty. You know what I mean? Anyway, over at number 6, we have A Plague Tale: Requiem. This is the follow-up to 2019's Plague Tale: Innocence, which was an incredibly underrated, and I keep saying that about so many games in this list, but seriously, it was a single-player narrative adventure game, and it was pretty awesome. It had cool puzzles, it had little interesting bits of stealth and combat and some good horror elements. Requiem looks to continue the tale of Amicia and her brother Hugo, with new locations, new characters, a crossbow. It's a cinematic trailer, so there's not too much to go on. But still, the original, a lot of people slept on it. It's worth checking out. And now we know that A Plague Tale: Requiem is releasing in 2022. Next, over at number 5, we have Tiny Tina's Wonderland, which technically was revealed at the Summer Game Fest. I know we're kind of breaking our own rules here. It doesn't matter too much, other than the fact that this was actually leaked a week or so before, so we did know about it. And it does sound pretty interesting, especially if you're a fan of Borderlands. It's like a new spin on the formula, more of a fantasy style spin on things. You can completely create your own character. And apparently it serves as a good new entry point for people who've never played a Borderlands game, with an interesting emphasis on comedy, considering the amount of voice actors they have involved. If you ask me, I'm pretty interested in a new spin on Borderlands. I think it's time. And the game is apparently releasing in 2022. Next, over at number 4, we have Stranger of Paradise: Final Fantasy Origin. This is, of course, the spin-off Final Fantasy game from Team Ninja, the people most recently behind Nioh and Nioh 2, and they're taking their twist on the Soulsborne formula and bringing it to Final Fantasy. Honestly, at first glance, the trailer is weird and kind of rough, but the connections to an original Final Fantasy game is pretty sweet. There is actually a demo available, and combat-wise, it seems like people are really digging it, especially after the demo had some kinks worked out where it didn't work for the first day or so. Still, the best thing about this is the chaos memes. Thank you for those, internet. We love you. We're definitely gonna be talking about this one a lot, I'm betting. It's releasing in 2022. Next, over number three, we have Guardians of the Galaxy from Square Enix and Eidos Montreal. This thing was heavily rumored and leaked for a long time, and it's actually launching pretty soon. Unlike Avengers, Guardians is a third-person single-player adventure game, which we really like, to be honest. And you simply play as Star-Lord, and you control the other Guardians and kind of give them orders and stuff, which is an interesting spin on things. Hopefully it allows for some focus. We have some storytelling, we have different conversational choices, and a good dash of humor, of course, as there should be. And although the combat looks a little rough, we're looking forward to this. A new interpretation of some of our favorite comic characters is always welcome, especially because Groot looks really cool and they gave Rocket a beard. We're into that. I don't know. Fingers crossed this doesn't get delayed. This is going to be a multi-platform release, and it's releasing on October 26th, 2021. Next, over to number two, we have Rainbow Six Extraction. This is formerly known as Rainbow Six Quarantine, and what it is more of a PvP shooter in the Rainbow Six Siege formula, but with a dash of bio-horror. Honestly, we got some XCOM vibes from the trailer, but still, this game has gone dark for a while, and we're happy to see it reemerge, and we're looking forward to playing it September 16th, 2021. Now down to number one, an interesting one, Stalker 2, Heart of Chernobyl. Yes, you saw it debuted at the Xbox thing, but we know now that this is coming to PlayStation platforms. Apparently, according to news reports, is a timed console exclusive for Xbox. It's also coming to PC, but apparently that timed console exclusivity is only 3 months. So we're hoping that we see Stalker 2 on PlayStation right after that exclusivity window ends. And regardless of the platform, it just looks like a damn good game. Graphically gorgeous, but hopefully capturing a tone and atmosphere that was the groundbreaking original Stalker games. That's what we're looking forward to the most. So April 28th, 2022, as of right now, is the release date for PC and Xbox, and that exclusivity window is 3 months, so hopefully we'll see it then. Those are some games that are coming to PlayStation platforms revealed at E3 2021. We definitely want to know what you're looking forward to in the comments. Definitely tell us for research purposes. It helps us cater our videos to you guys. Let's talk about anything E3 down in the comments. And if you enjoyed this video and maybe learned about a new game, clicking the like button is the best way you can help us out. We would really appreciate that. And if you're new, consider subscribing, maybe hitting that notification bell because we put out new videos every single day. But as always, thanks for watching. We'll see you guys next time.